Okay, I'm going to do a quick little demo of some fish for the kids now, or anyone really that hasn't done much watercolour before. We'll keep it really nice and simple. So what we're going to do, I'll show you first of all what you're going to need. I'm going to use a pencil and eraser. I'm going to use some red paint. I've just got some cad red. A little bit of black or dark blue paint. I'm using some indigo, but whatever you've got in your palette, you just need black and red. And I'm going to use three different brushes. So I have two medium-sized brushes and a small one here. I'll show you the shapes that those make and why I've picked those. So the first one is nice and pointy. So if I show you the shape, it's got this nice point on the end. This one here is a bit round on the end, so it will make a slightly blunter shape. You can see that's what I'm after. And this one, this little one, is just so that I can get some lines in. All right, so you need some clean water. I've got my palette here. So we'll start off and I'll show you the shape that you need to draw. So we're going to think of a squashed out grain of rice. Rossini, maybe, something like that. That's the body of the fish. Don't do as many pencil lines as I'm doing here. I'm doing that quite dark just so that you can actually see what I'm drawing. Then I'm going to give myself just a little bit of an indication of the tail. So I've just got two little straight lines. Then on the fish itself, I'm going to divide it into thirds. One, two, three. And on this first third here, I'm just going to put a little fin. Got a little fin up the back as well. And that's all I'm going to do for the drawing. So then I'm ready to paint. So I've got some that I've drawn up here. All right, now what we're going to do is we're going to do the tail and these fins straight onto dry paper. The body of the fish, we're actually going to wet it down with clean water and we're going to drop paint into that while it's still wet. So two different types of painting. The dry, you'll get very controlled strokes and sharp edges because the paint won't run anywhere. In the body where the paper's wet, when we drop in there, you'll see the paint will move all over the page. Okay, so I'm going to keep this really easy. All I'm going to do is get a brush. And I'll do it twice so you can see. First things first, clean water, and I'm just going to paint the body of the fish with clean water. Now, go to your pencil line and remember that the paint will go anywhere where the paper is wet. So if you accidentally come out of those lines, just let the page dry, and when it's dry, you can come and wet the paper again. So you just have to wait, be patient. Okay, so I come up around its nose. Then I'm going to get, I'm going to squeeze myself some more paint. So if you're using your little dried up palettes, you just need to make sure you get enough water into your little block of paint to get sort of a creamy consistency of paint. So what we're going to do is we're going to start on the tail with my pointy brush. I'm going to get a mix of creamy paint. So I've got some water in there, but it's not milky. It's cream consistency in there. So I'm going to draw two strokes, and that's the tail. Then I'm going to switch to the brush with the round end. I'm going to do one fin, the other fin. Doesn't matter if it touches into that water because we're going to come in there now anyway. Then I'm going to get some more paint, still creamy, and just drop some paint in. I'll be careful around the nose of the fish. Now, I don't want to paint everything, and it's really easy to, you'll start putting in a bit here, a bit there, and all of a sudden you'll just have one big red fish. So I want you to be light with your hand, only put a little bit in, and once you start to fiddle, come out. So I need to let that dry. So I'll do it again on this fish. I might turn it around. I could do this one coming that way, but my natural hand motion, I prefer to do the strokes that way. So I'm going to turn this around and do it this way to make it easier for me. All right, so again, I'll wash this brush. Same idea that I'm gonna wet down the body first. Now the reason I could do the tail and the fins and then come and wet down in here, but I want the page wet, but I don't want it really saturated. So the time that it takes me to do these bits, this will be about the right wetness. So coming here, again painting to the edges. My water's not all that clean now, it's a bit red. Be careful up on the nose. Okay, then I'm going to do the same thing again. I'm going to pick up some red paint. One, two, and this is sort of what I want you to take away from it, that's just two strokes of the brush. You don't need to think overly hard about that. You don't need to worry about it. Just the brush stroke. It's getting the shape of the brush for the particular shape that you want is what you're after. That didn't articulate that very well, but I'm using the shape of the brush to make my fins. So that's my round one. Then I'm going to come in again and just put a bit of paint through. Now these fish come in all sorts of different colour combinations. So you can use whatever you like in here. I could put some black. What have I got? What black spike? I've got some either indigo, or you can put some yellow. I'm going to put a tiny bit of a Payne's grey just because I like the way it behaves. You might not have that, but whatever you've got in your palette that you like. Because while it's still wet, I can add bits and let that paint run. And that's really what I want you to do, is see how the paint behaves on the wet page versus on the dry paper. So if I've got less water on my brush than on the page because I'm just tidying up a couple of those edges. So you could use yellows, oranges. Well, if you were going to do orange, I'd let it mix on the page. Put some yellow and put some red in and let it mix on the page rather than mixing it in your palette. All right. Then I need to let that fully dry. Have I got any that I can do it on? Because then we need to add, because that's still really wet, we need to add some eyes and a fin. I'm just looking for one. All right, maybe this over here. So what we want to do now is I rub some pencil lines off here. These are just some scraps of paper. Don't really like that one. More on here maybe. And that's dry. So I want you to put some eyes on. For the eyes, just get a little bit of black and a little mark on the side. Don't put the eyes on the top because it'll look really weird. So here's one where I've shown if you put the two eyes on the top of the fish, it doesn't look right. So you've got to put it on the side of the face. So here and here. And you can put, with this guy here, I'm going to strengthen this line down the middle. And if you want, you can put some lines through the fins. You don't have to. You can leave it as loose as you want. And something else that you can do if you're feeling adventurous is you can put a slight shadow. So I'm going to get a bit of black with my red. And this fish is completely dry. I'm going to come on here on the side, clean my brush and just move that line up a bit. So what I'm aiming to do is just make it a little bit darker on the side of the fish. I've got too much black then, I need to get some red. Just to make it a little bit more 3D. This fish was pretty messy, so it's a little bit tricky. Probably a bit more red. You can fiddle with these for as long as you like. What you probably will find is that it's better if you don't fiddle, it's a nicer result. Alright. We've got some water there. And the other thing you can do if you decide that you want the colours stronger, because it dries really light, is you can come in and put onto the dry page. Probably this brush is probably too small. Strengthen the colours and put a little bit more in. You can see the stronger red. But again, being careful not to fill in the whole shape. You do want to leave some of your bits of white. You can see that that gives you a stronger colour. If I go back to these ones, it's still not dry. But what I can do, I can do another one going underneath if I like. So we really should wait until this is dry, because if you touch the paint, you can get yourself into trouble. All right, so pretending that this one's dry, I can then come and again wet down the shape, being careful not to touch. Well, probably doesn't really matter. You'll get some nice bleeds and effects if you do touch that other fish. There you go, you can see that going there. Come and wet this bit. And I'm going to do the same thing. So one, two, without thinking. One, two. That one gets a bit trickier, I have to, because he's underneath. I'll just stretch that out a little bit. Okay, and then putting the splodges of colour into the wet paint. So really, it's this getting the paint to run that I want you to practice, because otherwise you could be painting it with acrylic or oil or, you know, coloured pencils. I want you to start learning how to get the water to do the work for you. When that was fully dry, you could put shadows on this one underneath to show that this fish is on top. I'm not going to do that now. I'm just going to pick up a bit of yellow and put in a bit of that. And so any colours you like, you can put into this. So I've got one here that's got blacks and yellows in it. Put a bit more. All right, let that dry. This one isn't quite dry, but I'll see if I can... Oh, no, I went for black. I meant to go for red. Okay, take a bit of red. Get that down there. See if this one's sort of... I don't really want to do the veins on that. I'm going to put another bit there. That shape's not quite right. And I might just put the eyes on this one, and then I might stop, because it's all a little bit wet for me to do. But that gives you, yeah, it's running a little bit. That gives you an idea of what we're going for. And really, it's just about playing, seeing what colours work for you, what colours you like, and then potentially doing some finer detail. Like I might come back into here when it's dry and I don't like, there's this bit of a chink there, so I can come back and just fill in that little bit there. Watercolour isn't as unforgiving as people would have you believe. All right. Okay, so have a play with those, whatever colours you like. Use lots of scraps of bits of paper and just keep it simple and try and get these nice brush strokes in, so you're getting the shape of your brush. Okay, have fun.